Yes, you know that. I told you that. That was all a part of the plan.
It's not my relationship, this is my relation.
My relation.
This is not my position in time, this is not my nation.
No nation.
I am a citizen of the world.
The world.
I am a boy.
You are a girl.
Today we're going to talk about self-sabotage in the process.
Oh my gosh.
So sometimes what happens when we're reaching towards goals that are bigger than ourselves and we have big dreams and big goals, we have these limiting beliefs that cause us to sabotage our main process and our main movement. Has that ever happened to you? Have you ever been in a situation where you felt like you were sabotaging the very dream and the very thing that you were trying to get? Has that ever happened to you? Ever? Mm-hmm.
That time when you had the memory, that thought, that dream, that one that brought you together, that thing that drove you down the upstream. You know what I mean? When you were like ready to spawn, when the light of the dawn inspired you to do and change things inside of you, to rearrange things. The time swings. No one knows what's going on inside you but you. But until you do, who can? No one. That's true. Recognize that strength and weakness, sometimes they change places and faces. They sometimes rearrange the spaces inside minds that see us. They want to be us, but we have to believe in us. Trust that this is one thing that mankind has. We have to give back the thing that blindly we have taken from the earth. You know, that birth thing, that L-O-V-E.
Where do I come from? You good?
We good.
I was born in the Bronx. The motherfucking Bronx. That's where I came from. The heartland of hope. Because if you make it out of the Bronx, it's like New York, if you can make it there, you can make it anywhere. If you can make it out of the Bronx, ooh. For example, a black male, the life expectancy of a black male born in the Bronx around the time that I was born was like 23 years old. You're gonna live to 23. And at 23, you're gonna die of a gunshot wound to the head, either from your best friend, your girlfriend, or a police officer. Those are the chances that you have when you come from the Bronx and you're a black male. So you get to choose, which is it gonna be? A bullet in the head from your best homie, a bullet in the head from your girl, or a bullet in the head from the police. So I was like, oh, this may not be the train I wanna be on when 23 rolls around. So that's where I came from, and that's why my ass ain't there right the fuck now. And if you notice, in the last 20 years, how many black men have been killed by bullet wounds from police officers? In the beginning, you might have thought it was ridiculous to say something like that. But now that they got all cameras showing you exactly why it is I left, now you understand.
That's right, Matt Greedy, your international marketing master for all you artists out there who need your love. When Matt Greedy call you up, he real greedy. Don't worry about it, because we do your marketing. Everybody said, what type of marketing y'all do for them? Yes, wow, people on the island. I said, this, you know, the big stuff. I said, what is the big stuff? I said, what's your marketing plan? I said, marketing plan? What you think this is, man? This is the plan. We make the shit. We throw it out there. When it fit the fan.
One love, one more chance. Hold on loose, but don't let go now. We got time for one last dance. It's time to light it up and start the show now. Just live it, live. That's right. My motto, live my life this way. Don't live it alone. It's time I make my dream my home. I'm living today. That's right. I'm gonna live my life this way. Just live it alone. It's time I make my dream my home.
Hello.
every single day you get up and you're living the dream, every single day when you say your affirmations in the morning and at night before you go to bed, when you wake up, you're in that world that you're talking about, already doing what it is that you say that you're going to be doing in your dream life. All of a sudden, your dream woman walks into the picture as if out of a movie. She's smart, she's gorgeous, she's funny, she's juicy, she's voluptuous. And you think, wow, maybe I did the right thing.
You think? Mm-hmm. You think it looks like you're standing in the movie?
A little bit, no?
Hola, hello.
Hola.
Welcome.
Thank you.
Wow, it's a real investment.
Yes, of course. The more money, you always just become the bank.
If you don't like the art, you can always cash in.
Yeah.
Monty is the fillable fuck. Going for buggers, I bought a chopper. I got a big drum to hold a honey. Going for nothing, I'm ready to air it out on all these niggas. I can see I'm running. She talked to my mama, she hit me on FaceTime. Check up on me and my brother. Really the baby, she know that the youngest son was always guaranteed to get the money. Okay, let's go. She know that the baby boy was always guaranteed to get the loot. She know what I do, she know if I run from it. I'ma pull it out, shoot. PTSD, I'm always waking up a cold sweat like I got the flu.
Which one?
She started killing me in front of her before the age of two. And I can kill another one too.
With the intro on it.
No, I prefer this version.
Then the original one.
Let's
go. Oh, yeah.
Brand new Lamborghini, fuck a cop car. With a pistol on my hip like I'm a cop. Have you ever met a real nigga rock star? This ain't no guitar, it's just a clock.
Coming to you live from Berlin. This is Ibiza Lifestyle TV, the Berlin Diaries at the Hemp Parade.
So I'll tell you, really honestly, there's not really a way to explain it. There's not really a way to express it. It's because when I was living in the Bronx and in the city, all I could think about was all the hustle that was there and the fact that you had to grind like crazy to do every fucking thing. And the grind is a pain in the ass. Nobody wants to grind. So it was eating you, the city. You could feel it eating you. And here, instead of the city eating you, what you have is a bit more of nature nourishing you. Just a different way of living, a different life.
I think now what's this thing that's happening is really like, it's taking it back to the really, really older days where you saw your friend because you walked to their house and knocked on their door and they were home and you hung out with them all day. And then like you may have gotten dropped off maybe the next day or maybe 2 days later, you know, and then you went back home. You didn't see as many people, but you saw people more deeply. And because we're forced not to be able to get into big groups, people are going back to this, you have to do it, you know, like you see less people, but you see them more deeply. And I think that's also important too, because we were getting too fast. It's like, there's good and there's bad in everything. Look at where we were right before all the shit stopped. It was a bit too much, huh? It was a bit too fast, huh? It was a bit too disposable. It was a bit too laissez-faire. It was like, no one's saying that, you know, illness or, no. But the speed at which we were moving as humanity and going through all of our things was a bit too much. And we knew we needed to stop it, but God, what? I'm really moving, I'm rushing, I'm in a rush right now. I don't have time to stop it. And then it gets stopped like, and everyone's like, but wait a minute. Didn't we just say we wanted climate change to fucking chill out, but we know we have to do the thing that's so difficult, and now look, it's changing in front of you because the airports are not full anymore. So there's less planes, so you have clearer skies. So, I mean, all these things that are changing, you know, it's like we still have environmental problems, but they've slowed the fuck down because we were so full into it, like wreck the planet into it, highball, the breakneck speed. So if we can just go back a bit to the old school way and take the lesson from that and be like, it's not necessarily a bad thing, go back to nature. Spend more time in the forest. Spend more time with your friends and your family and less time trying to be in Madrid with 60 people in a bar. It's like, why? Go plant some fucking seeds with your neighbor and grow some food. The supermarket may be closed next year. It's like, this is like how we need to do it, but no one forced us to do it. And this is like kind of forcing us. And I don't necessarily think it's good to be forced, but the other side is the nature is not complaining about it. The nature's like, oh, you tell me 4 million toilets didn't flush in Ibiza this summer and the nature is like happy that didn't happen? Like just the toilets that would have flushed that didn't flush because, you know? That one tiny thing makes such a big difference in a place so small. How many people flushed the fucking toilets and took all our fucking water to do absolutely nothing, you know, but fuck the sewer system up? So this is the part that it's like, meh. We were eating ourselves. Stop.